in a place not too far from Toronto, and it died not too long ago. But beyond the farthest reaches of time, before farts are found funny, in a time where insults were only made from combining male genitalia and facial features such as dick nose and chin, with pure brutal skill, Battlesmash smites all other bands to the ground in pain and dishonor, and stands victorious at the pinnacle of musical success. Turns out it's about $21.95 a week, give or take $20. Back when the champions of Jesus, U2, were still a Christian band, Satan himself cried out for his own group of heroes. His disappointment was great when Battlesmash answered that call.
Attention, local. You are now a bear witness to the first Battlesmash show in over a decade. If you don't know who they are, this is a good time to say there will be no refunds. If you do know who they are, may God have mercy on your souls.
It's great to be in Oshawa tonight.
Amazing to be in Acton. Acton, you're amazing. What is... Who's doing that?
That's distracting to me.
It is. Very distracting. Anyways, we're Battlesmash.
Mike, is that Mike from Michigan in the back? You were yelling at me earlier. Like, and now you're fucking acting like this?
What? Get him out of here. Get Mike out of here. Yeah, that guy right there. Yeah, him.
These people
gotta go.
Didn't pay him good money to see this.
No, it's been like, what, 25 years since we saw
this? This is a poorly thought out joke.
I know. What a terrible piece of... Are you done? Yeah, they got him. They got him.
I saw that tackle. That was beautiful.
Thanks, guys. Thanks, guys. We're Battlesmash.
The bot will smash.
What a series of unfortunate events for Michael Michigan. Made all the way trip here up to Acton to find out that he was going to be kicked out unsuspectingly. Hey, Mike from Michigan, by the way.
I'm glad he said it on the... I never liked him.
He said it was Minnesota, but I'm telling you it was Michigan.
I spit on him at first out of respect, but next time I see him, I'm going to spit on him out of disrespect.
Disrespect.
Thank you.
Yeah,
next time. Thank you.
Anyways.
Well, we've been having a good time so far, but
yes,
I think we're going to tone it down a little bit now.
Keith Vine is here from the United States of America.
What did they say? Yes, we are. And,
You know what reminds me of the United States was Lou Beerious, the American that we had in our band back in the 80s. Yeah.
He was a fan of the States, his homeland, the motherland, as he called it. I don't know if he's actually American. He kept saying the motherland. But anyways, yeah, he was a good friend of ours, and actually we lost him. It's going on a couple decades now.
Yeah, at least 22 years.
23.
Maybe 32, who knows.
I wasn't keeping track.
Time flies when you live forever.
I do miss the fella, and we were just playing out in the backyard one day, just having a good time, just a couple of couple of young spring chickens, and we knocked over a large bee's nest, fell to the ground, and it swarmed all of us. And
it was like Macaulay Culkin and My Girl.
It was like that, and it was like Nicolas Cage in Wicker Man. The bees are in my eyes!
That happened?
You guys remember that?
To Nicolas Cage?
Yeah.
He's one of my favorite actors.
Wicker Man, check it out. He gets bees in his eyes.
I think I'll check out National Treasure tonight. Anyway, this was called Get Into My Car.
The last thing I said to my bro, as he was stung by thousands of bees. Next up on the docket here.